They're passionate, they are idealistic, they want to go out and change the world.
Provides the opportunity to both take care of the elderly as well as create an industry that is profitable while doing so.
Frankly, I don't see it as a professional choice so much as a life choice.
A sort of security financially in case of the risk.
Independence and the freedom to move from one domain to the other.
We have to be sensitive to their needs.
Nobody wants to be a beneficiary. We banned the use of the term beneficiaries.
Sanjeev Kumar, the Goat Trust. I did my graduation from BHU, Banaras Hindu University in Agriculture. Then I did my post-graduation Master's in Dairying, Livestock Production and Management from National Dairy Research Institute, Karnal, NDRI Karnal, Haryana in fact. Oh, that was interesting. I was just in second year and Pradhan has come. We are not, entitled to go into campus interview. It was just for a fun, I sit there. And then they started talking poultry with the tribal community. So how a professional can work into the rural areas and can make changes. In those days, those ideas were interesting to me, but at the same time, the traditional career looking traditional career and this type of career was a bit wild to me, but I found it adventurous, and that's why I was the first candidate out of the 130 people there who volunteered to work for that, and I remained unfortunately I remained the one only. EDI had an advertisement. I went into the Times of India paper and I saw they had a post for faculty in NGO management. So once I worked 7 years, I thought that the knowledge should go to the next generation also. And I found this idea again interesting, to teach others, to let them others understand how the NGO sector works. And that's why I went into the interview. They selected me through the interview. See, when we so social enterprise, the every job there should have a sort of freedom. If you social enterprise wants to grow, two things will have to create. One is the freedom and second is the ownership. Ownership of a social enterprise has to be a social concept rather than an individualistic concept. So whenever one comes into a job, he expects this enterprise belongs to me as much as others. If it happens the same ownership pattern which a corporate have, other social entrepreneurs there, because they are maybe in a small way, but they all are social entrepreneurs, that's why he is also taking a risk. So he wants to be shared, reward also to be shared. So from my own experiences or many of my students, I found when they didn't get enough space, enough the recognition of his work within the company and outside, then they leave the social enterprise. And many social enterprise starts and then it becomes a monopolistic type of thing, the same people whose enterprise it is. See, normally people look into the salaries on a prima facie, on the face value, but what they actually look for, what I perceive, is the freedom to work, the innovations, the scope of innovations, and the impact of the work. I have trained over 300 people in a different spheres, sometimes technical, sometimes social enterprise. But 20 of them has been full-fledged working in now in the social sector in a various capacity, mostly as a social enterprise management. Most of them were MBAs, did management degrees. They had some jobs, but they were not satisfied with their jobs, and that was the time when they came into my contact, and I tried to understand what is the mismatch between that. The first thing is what you want to do in life. There are something meaningful, meaning everybody looks into the life. And once this question becomes critical to your life, then this, why I left EDI, because I found I want to do something different, something which is more meaningful to me. And with a freedom, Similarly, this happens with many people. They want to do something, they are doing something, but they don't get meaning into it. So I think this has been the prime factor for me and many others whom I mentor to the meaningful life, the what he is doing to see the result of that, positive result of that. Yeah, people get access to me through social networking sites like LinkedIn, Facebook, but this I will grow type of where social entrepreneurs profiles are put into. But I think this is not sufficient enough. Just now, there may be dedicated site for social entrepreneurs that would be more helpful.